humbled I am to be here today. I saw Sonny said I was the former chairman of Silverbirds. He didn't give me a chance to resign. He retired me on national television. But that's okay. All my life, I've always been attracted to public service for the right reasons. But first of all, let me thank all of the recipients here today, politicians, businessmen, those of you who have accomplished great things for this great nation. When I decided to run for public, I decided to run for the right reasons. I was concerned about the poverty in the land and the inability of governments, federal, state, local governments to function at the level we ought to. In seeking public office, I looked at the national budget, state budget, and local government budget. I tried to understand why Nigeria was not as developed as it ought to be. And what I saw was shocking and very alarming. Those of us in the private sector understand how we ought to run a company and things we should do and shouldn't do. At the federal budget, a couple of things shook me up. For instance, 1% of the national budget is spent on pilgrimages for the Muslims and the Christians. 3% of the national budget is spent on the National Assembly for 469 people. 30% of the national budget is spent on 1.2 million civil servants. 88% of the national budget is spent on recurrent expenditure, and only 12% is spent on capital expenditure. State governments have no money. Outside, I was talking to the Ekiti State governor, and he cannot pay salaries. Forget about capital development and debts that he inherited. Most states in the country today, if they were companies, would file for bankruptcy. And no company would loan them any money, the federal government inclusive. To say we are broke is an understatement. A few things must happen. We must grow the economy, and we must shrink the way we spend money. The problem in Nigeria is not about the North versus the South. It's not about Christianity versus Islam. It's not about APC versus PDP. The problem in Nigeria is right versus wrong. I was interviewed by Bloomberg magazine the other day, and he asked me the problems about the Northeast and the South-South. And I said to him, the issue with the Northeast is not about religion, and the issue about the South-South is not what you think it is. The issue is very simple. We have a small minority of people, the leadership of Nigeria, consuming all the resources of our nation and leaving the rest of us in abject poverty. That cannot work. We must learn to be humble. We must learn to conserve what we have. And we must learn to be kind enough for the rest of us to have enough food to eat, our children to go to school, healthcare facilities for everyone, education, jobs, infrastructural development for our people, and a population control policy. 170 million people, most of us live on $2 a day, not enough money to survive, and yet we get angry when we get robbed. We don't understand why a young kid has access to an AK-47, a grenade, a bomb, making it possible for them to get guns and kill us because we do not look after them. We pay no attention to the least of us. And our response is to live in big buildings with high wired fences, buy bulletproof cars, have more bodyguards, proportional amount of policemen protecting us and not the poor. That cannot work. We must come together and understand that we must all grow and develop together as a people. Anyone you leave behind, you create a problem for the rest of us. It is not enough for you to send your children to schools in Switzerland, buy your houses in Dubai, live a life of extreme wealth, and don't expect those you leave behind to want to take you out. The young people belong to what I call the MTV generation. If five presidents could not shut down Fela Nicolas Bokuti, you see 100 million people. The world has changed. The people have changed. You think you're smart and you think your lifestyle is not being watched by those you govern. When you seek public office, you seek public office to lead by example. You do not seek public office to be the lords over the people who vote you into office. When I ran for office, I met my constituency. I used to joke in those days that the people who were poor lived under the bridge. When I ran for office in Bayelsa, there were no bridges. I found out they lived under the tree. It was that bad. My village where I come from, they've never seen a car. They have no petrol station. Have no water. They have erosion. Where my grandmother was born is 1 kilometer in the Atlantic Ocean. Poverty everywhere. Poverty breeds anger and hunger. Hunger and anger breeds violence. And in the end, we cannot control it. We must be conscious of the people we lead. It is not enough to make great speeches. I see politicians on TV. Special occasions, they say, let us pray. Maybe some of them are not familiar with the concept of prayer. You pray for the food you're about to receive, not the food you ate all by yourself. We need change. The world has changed, and we must change. It's not just talking about change, we must have the real deal. Changes, real changes here and changes now. And for us to change, we must understand what drives our people. There is too much hunger in the land. So I'm going to make a deal as your senator. I ran for office to be the senator of all people, not just Bayelsa East, because we have a crisis on our hands. Let's make a deal. Let's say, for instance, to reduce expenditure, only the president and the vice president fly first class, as an example. Let's say the National Assembly, governors, fly business class. Everybody else flies economy. Is that a deal? When you travel abroad, you don't stay in a $4,000 hotel paid for by taxes. I run a business. We employ 1,000 people. I've never stayed in a hotel more than $300 in my life. Not because I can't afford to. But when I think at the end of the month I must make payroll, I must pay taxes, how can I justify staying in a $4,000 hotel? It doesn't make any sense. I have never flown first class in my life, ever. As a young man, I flew Nigeria Airways. Then I flew Virgin Nigeria. Now I fly Arik. And I do so on purpose. I have a choice, but I choose to fly my carrier to do. You cannot sit here and talk about nationalism and patriotism. And when the lights are turned off, you spend 1.5 million naira going to London, that could feed a whole family for a whole year. You drink a bottle of champagne, that could educate a child for 1 year. It makes no sense. The problem in Nigeria is the rich versus the poor. The crisis we have is a class warfare. And let me say this, and I've said it for 35 years. If we do not control our consumption behavior, we don't control it. These young kids, they may not be able to read and write, but they have access to the internet. They knew how to make a bomb. They knew how to make a grenade. They knew where to find a gun. They knew how to pull the trigger. When they get hungry and angry, you become the victim. You don't have enough money to hide or run. You will be caught and you will die. So, I used to be chairman of the Fela Foundation, so. But let me say this. Let me say this. The world has changed. We have not changed. When we go abroad, we go look for aid. We go to Congress, British Parliament. The man we speak to, my colleagues, they go to work by bus. They come to work by train, by taxi. When we go in there representing the federal government of Nigeria, we go in a private jet. We wear a $1 million watch. Our women carry a $100,000 bag. And they look at us and they say, you represent the poor people. I see it on TV, poor people. It hunger, but you come here representing us with a $1 million watch. How do you think we look? We look like we have no conscience. We have no conscience. What is the qualification to seek public office? School certificate. What university teaches us about compassion? We must care about the least of us. If we don't, we pay the ultimate price and destruction. Mr. Ganifayomi, you said to me, you listened to my speeches, and you will hold me accountable. I urge you to hold me accountable. When I go to the National Assembly, I will represent the least of us. I will raise my voice. I will speak about the issues. Damn the consequence. I will speak about the issues. We are a poor country. Nigeria is too poor for our leaders to act like multi-billionaires, and Nigeria is too rich for our people to be so poor.